you clout chasing, trying to make the people feel you. Boys need to slow it down, I'm talking real screw. Penthouse at the top with the clear view. Oh, look, I don't like your energy. I don't like that. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no, probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. Let's go. You not my kind, not no kin to me. Heard you told my girl about all of them that's DMing me. Why they hogging up the recipe? Heard they talking like I can't let Ken Wallace get ahead of me. Know your heart full of jealousy. All that acting tough, damn, this must be a parody. Okay, 101 ain't no comparing me. Okay, wait, 2-on-2, that's like four. They be sharing me. Okay, they working like the red dude. Rent, got them doing, that's what I'm into. Yeah, if I'm in it, then I own it, not a rental. No, I've been plotting on the.
This place first opened way back in 1957. We are inside legendary Lambeau Field here in Green Bay. Tonight, we start week 11 of the NFL season with a good one here between the Tennessee Titans and the Green Bay Packers. Season has hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. This defense for the Titans, they were terrific last week in the win over Denver.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game. And I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one. But 7? That seems almost impossible. But we watched it happen.
Second down, here's Barkley again. And he'll fight for a couple as the tackle is made at about the 32. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 3. Third down, Corral. It's caught by Funchess. And he's going to have the Packers' first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6. The Packers hit 3-7 now in the year. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. And I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Corral to throw on 1st and 10. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
On 2nd and 10, Corral. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
You got to give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and get some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down. Here we go.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. On third down, Corral. Over the middle, he's got Chenault. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Packer first down. Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat, is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. Corral looking to pass. Second down. They'll set up the screen to Barkley. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. A good-looking drive for the Packers so far. It's a first down.
And as you're game planning as a staff, you go through all the different ways you can neutralize the other guy's pass rushers. Extra linemen, leave a tight end in, bring the running backs back in to block. Or you can do this, a little simple screen pass, and it works to perfection.
A first down throw here for Corral. Looking for Crowder, and it's intercepted. Trent McDuffie with a pick, and the Titans force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football. But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. They find some open field here. He stiff arms him. Titans. Tony Pollard with his fourth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Titans have taken the early lead on the road here at Lambeau.
Well, that's how you take advantage of an early turnover. A sudden change situation, meaning ball's turned over. How's both sides going to handle it? One side handled it way better. They went right out on the field and put the ball in the end zone.
One play, that just added insult to injury.
Yeah, that just tells you on the defensive side, they didn't come out ready to go, still reeling from the fact that the ball got turned over.
And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. From the gun, Corral. That's for Bateman, and it's intercepted. Now he's hit on the return. It's a loose football. And the Packers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line. Well, do you want to unpack that one, or do you want me to?
You're the boss.
We get the interception. Then really, he's just too loose with the football on the return, and he coughs it right back up the other way.
I've seen this happen in an NFL game, and boy, did it cost someone. San Francisco at Atlanta a few seasons ago. Atlanta throws the interception. San Francisco runs it back. Game is salted away. Fumbles on the return. Atlanta gets it back. Drives down, kicks the game-winning field goal.
How about that? And a crazy situation we just saw there. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. It's the first time that they've looked his way tonight, and he comes up with a first down on the play. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it. Occasionally, you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield. Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
On second and nine, Corral. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. And Nick Bosa so quick on the outside, he gets in there to bring him down. We had a pretty good idea that they were going to pressure this young quarterback, and that's now two sacks here in the first quarter.
And, yeah, this is a secret to exactly nobody, because if you're a rookie quarterback, you know you're going to see pressure. Defenses want to see how you're going to handle it.
Or Corral is intercepted again. That's number three. Trent McDuffie with a pick, and he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. So his struggle is just continuing here in the first half, throwing the football. Charles, now three interceptions.
And they don't feel like they're just great plays by the defense. There's a sense that maybe he's a little careless with the football now. So some of the great coaches in the past, you know what they've always said? I can't teach you, obviously, because you're not listening. So maybe the bench can teach you. He's got to be careful now. He might get pulled.
A tale of two extremes. First carry, he went for a bundle. His second goes backward.
And how many times have we seen that happen? Because you get that big carry, and you come back, and you're all fired up. And sometimes you force a run a little bit, right? Trying to break off that big carry again. And instead, it works opposite.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. He'll get this into the hands of Van Jefferson. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll go with Pollard here on first down, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. 6-0 our score after one. Second and 11 now. Goff. His throw incomplete.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Throwing on third, Goff. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Oh, that's gonna hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Gonzalez's kick is good, and that will make this a 9-point lead. Well, they already had the early lead, and they get the interception, Charles, and now they add three more with the field goal.
Yeah, they're in control of how this game is playing out so far. You mentioned the early lead. Now they're expanding on it, getting plays on both sides of the ball. A winning recipe if they can keep this up.
And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. They come off a victory over the weekend, but now the quick turnaround here for this Thursday night game. How does that affect how teams like this approach these short turnarounds?
Well, wins and losses always factor into, you know, how you're getting ready for the next game. But equally as important when you have the short turnaround, what is your injury situation? Are you losing key guys? And if so, how well have the backups prepared for this? Because you don't have much time to get them ready. They have to be ready before this week in order to play well in this game.
Looking to throw again on second down. Corral. Crowder's got it over the middle. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Corral to throw, first and 10. And this one is incomplete.
With a rookie quarterback out there, you're definitely going to find out how he handles adversity, because this one so far hasn't gone according to plan. He's got to fight through it and show him what he's made of.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Barkley off tackle left. Trucks over him. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It's a gain of 12, and the Packers have the first.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there is no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Corral with it on first down. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. The 20, 10, 5, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think they, were they a nickel? Did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning three safeties for big nickel. They just wanted to take away the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did, and came through with a big-time pick six.
This time, the extra point up and good. And that could be important, as that makes this a 16-point lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Taking it about the one. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Now, they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. A good pickup there, 26 yards. The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. Barkley inside handoff. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets him back now for second down.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in, and he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 40. 19 yards the pickup there. Move the chains.
Time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, be able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this a little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. On first down, Corral. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
I tell you what, it looks like he's shaking off that pick six just fine. It's not just defensive backs that have to have short memories. Quarterbacks utilize that as well. A much more confident throw right there.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Up the middle with Barkley. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Running again with Barkley on second down. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and four. Corral looking to throw. And he'll get this underneath, dropping it off for Barkley. And this won't be enough. Stopped a yard short after a gain of three. Fourth down.
Always important as a defender on third down to keep the play in front of you and make sure you don't give up enough space that they can make a move on you in the open field. Try as he might, he wasn't able to get to the first down marker. Excellent defense, good tackle.
So it was fourth and one down in the red zone, but they elect to take just the three.
And I'm a little surprised that that's how they decided to play it, that they didn't go for it there. But sometimes just take those 3 points and put them in your pocket. I just have one question for you, partner.
Okay.
Hip pocket or back pocket?
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Titans offense set to begin the drive. There's really no reason to change what they've been doing to this point. They've got the lead. They've looked good this first half.
I agree with you.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jaquan Brisker. And this one will be brought back to the 22. And Charles, that's now four interceptions over his last three halves of football, because remember, he threw three picks last week.
Starting to wonder if maybe defenses and those coordinators have identified something on tape with what he's doing. Maybe a movement, maybe the way he's moving his shoulders. Who knows what it could be? He could have a few tells out there that they're keying in on and allowing defenses to get to the football a little bit faster. People steal signals. Maybe sometimes they can figure out what the quarterback's doing just by his movements.
51 yards rushing for him now to this point.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
On second and a couple, Corral. And my goodness, another interception. Trent McDuffie with a pick. And the Titans are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line. Well, this is just crazy. He's got three interceptions, Charles, and we haven't even departed the first half of this ballgame.
I think if you're looking at the stats right now, you're saying, all right, who's the leading receiver? Well, can you flip it around and say that maybe he is and could be for the game the way that things are going right now? I think if it's him, he wants to be on the field at all times.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Goff. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Out of the gun, Goff. He's got a man, complete. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. 76. Now gone. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And the Packers are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. So they try to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got five big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. So we reach halftime here with the visiting Titans taking the lead into intermission. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. The Titans hold the lead, and they'll get the football first as the third quarter gets underway. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll go down at the 2-yard line. What a disaster there.
Only able to get it to the 2-yard line on his return. Not going to make a lot of friends on your team when you only get it that far.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And despite the turnovers, Charles, and they had multiple in that first half, they still have the lead as they begin this third quarter.
And they probably heard some conflicting tones at the half, don't you think? A lot of praise for what they did to get this lead, but also a little bit of scolding because they got to take better care of the football in the second half. But you and I both know the great leaders, they know how to give that little bit of vinegar in there and cover it with a big dose of honey.
They'll drop this underneath to Pollard, and they'll bring him down right around the 13. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Now a play fake, and it's gone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Gone. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Chris Barnes. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously, didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll try and get this run game going. This is Barkley. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. Nick Bosa using that speed to get in there and break that play up.
I know they'd love to take some heat off of that young quarterback, but so far, not much in the running game. And this won't help things either. A loss on that play.
First play of the drive, lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. Back to throw, Corral. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Third and long, Corral. And now here is another interception. Eddie Jackson picks it. And the Titans are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line.
Well, it's not the first time we've seen him give one up here during his rookie season. And in this case, zone coverage forced the mistake. He's made some strides week to week in how he's handling the different type of coverages that he's seeing, but clearly there's some growing still to do.
Here we go, fellas, here we go.
They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Tackle made by Foley Fanukasi, the former UConn Husky.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A first down there on a pickup of 25. Now a give here to Pollard. And a lane slowly materializing there as he'll get maybe a yard up to the 45.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
They go back to Pollard on second down. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. So not a lineman, but the tight end instead this time, drawing the holding call.
And more what you're getting with tight ends are guys who are much more receiver than blocker. They may be willing, but that might not be their thing. Oftentimes, they'll be the ones getting the penalties.
They go back to Pollard on second down. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. 85 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. To throw is gone. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Here's Jamie Gillen now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Following the punt return here, there is someone shaken up. But the medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break. They begin with a run by Barkley. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Corral. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. Here's J.K. Scott now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return, and it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive. Is it? And they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And a good-looking run there as he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18-yard line. And they get 17 more on that one and another first down. From the red zone now, gone. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Van Jefferson, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Titans are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that pushes the lead up to an even 20. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
The sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Here's Corral. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Now gone. Looks for the out route, and it's complete to Komet. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that's going to bring up third and two.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
The offense on third down tonight, they've only converted once in four tries. This time they face a third and two. Trying to run for it with Pollard. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Tony Pollard with his second touchdown of the night. And the Titans are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. Gonzalez to add the PAT. And that stretches the lead to 27. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And able to break this out all the way to the 38-yard line. Great return. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and nine looming. On third down, Corral. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be fourth and inches.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Fourth down, here's Corral. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line.
A feather in the cap for the defender, picking off one of the league's better quarterbacks so far this season. And add another feather in the cap for the coaches, too. Excellent game plan, and they had their guys aware of his ability to roll out and how to defend against it.
Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Finally, defensively, they have a little clip to show positive for actually stopping him running the football.
It's been a really long night for them, hasn't it? So they got a little bit of a win there, but let's face it, the vision that he's had running the football has carried his feet to the open spaces and the big yardage all night long.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled up the play, then they drilled him.
And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short of the first down marker. That'll be good for six, but now it's fourth down. Now Zane Gonzalez for the field goal try. He's going to need a little mustard on this one. It'll be a 51-yard attempt. Gonzalez's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three, and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so.
Now a hit and a loose football. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy because you want to make sure that the catch is secure. And a lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break. And you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short. So it'll be third and less than a yard. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. Third down, Corral. Open man is Bateman. It's complete. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. 27 yards there on a very nice third down conversion. So first and 10 now from the 30. Again, it's Corral. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Bobby McCain. And the Titans will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. But with this advantage, this defense knew that passes were coming, and they stayed in position, Charles, and picked one off here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, what a way to cap things off, huh? Because I think this is part of the game within the game. They see the scoreboard, they see what they can accomplish, and they went for it.
Historically, this is such a tough, loud venue, but you can hear a pin drop right now. A lot of fans long gone, not used to seeing a lopsided score like this. And they will take a knee here. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. So this one, a Tennessee Titan victory. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for the Titans, it's a win they needed, if for nothing else than their sanity, as they move to 4-6. And now they'll have a few extra days here before they face Cincinnati next week. Meanwhile, for Green Bay, they've fallen out of things now as they sink to 3-8. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Philly.
I'm really, really out for blood this time, look. just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Gonna tell a friend to tell a friend. They say success is the best revenge. Heard they was sleeping again. Say it no more. This is a rude awakening. Kicking the